We've got a swamp monster to catch.
Like, I'm tired of We've Got a Monster to Catch always being followed by us sitting alone in some terrifying place being used as bait.
I have noticed.
Seriously? I mean, it happens every single time.
Guess I've been preoccupied.
And that's what always happens next!
That rings a bell!
Like now!
Let her rip!
Eat hot sauce, foul beast!
The Grim Reaper strikes again! Quick, it's getting away!
Oh, no, it's not.
He's coming your way! Nice work, partner.
Amazing! Y'all caught the swamp monster!
He's no swamp monster.
Dwayne!
I can explain. I was just having some fun.
You can drop the act, Dwayne. Or should we call you by your other name? The Gentleman Bandit.
The Gentleman Bandit?
Yes, yes, I've obviously been discovered. Now, would somebody please remove this piece from my person? This is no way to treat a southern gentleman.
Dwayne wanted to scare everyone out of the swamp. Why? Because he was after the armored car he stole as the Gentleman Bandit. When Chomps foiled Dwayne's getaway, the armored car loaded with money became submerged in the swamp. Dwayne, aka the Gentleman Bandit, needed time to recover the money, but he could only work at night. The only problem was, that's when Bayou Pierre ran his swamp tours, so the swamp monster was born. Dwayne had come to town and got a job working with Bayou Pierre as the perfect cover while he planned his bank robbery. I realized he wasn't what he seemed when Pierre thought the Kingston University ring belonged to Dwayne, the same ring he lost the night of the robbery. Dwayne wasn't Kingston material, but the Gentleman Bandit was exactly the kind of high society type that would be a Kingston alumnus.
And I would have gotten away with it, too, if it wasn't for that meddling alligator.
Don't you mean meddling kids?
Hooray for Chomps, the hero gator! He always gets his man!
Chomps!
No, wait, no, we teamed up with Chomps. It was a collaborative effort.
Chomps!